come on. At ease. Good morning to each and every one of you here today as we celebrate this day of celebration for our veterans on this Veterans Day, November 11th. We're so honored to have each and every one of you as our guests, and we thank you each and every one for your service to our country. Today we are honored to have, catch my breath here, Emory-Riddle Aeronautical University, ROTC, would you give them a hand? Will you join me in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Join me in prayer. Dear Lord, today we honor our veterans. Worthy men and women who gave their best when they were called upon to serve and protect their country. We pray that you will bless them for their unselfish service in the continued struggle to preserve our freedoms, our safety, and our country's heritage. For all of us sake, God's people said, Amen. You may be seated. will now salute the branches of service and they play your song. Please stand and be recognized. Please give Emory Riddle Aeronautical University ROTC a big hand. We are so grateful for their presence today and all that they bring to us as military personnel. There is families here and brothers and sisters of military personnel outside of those who have actually served, and you served along with them in those sacrifices. The service of American veterans never truly ends. Even when they hang up their military uniforms for the last time, many still choose to protect us. Noah Schwartz was one of them, and after serving 5 years as a military police officer in the United States Army, the 591st NP Company, Noah returned to his home state and graduated from Indiana Law Enforcement Academy in May of 2022. As he drove past a restaurant last summer in Elwood, Indiana, he noticed an artist painting a large American flag mural covering the exterior of the building. Noah was excited, his patrol car, and complimented the painter for the patriotic rendering. The two briefly conversed, and the artist, Theodore Winters, thanked Noah for his military service. They then went on to their businesses, and a few hours later, Noah was tragically killed in the line of duty with a motorist allegedly shot him during a traffic stop. End of watch for Noah was July 31st, 2022. He was 24 years old. After hearing the news of Noah, Theodore immediately recalled their conversation and decided the mural would be dedicated to the fallen hero and veteran who gave everything to his country and community. Noah was embodied under the service and sacrifice. He was not alone. The U.S. Justice Department estimates about 25% of law enforcement officers of military background, bravely and dedicated to community, are common among veterans. Today is a day to honor all our men and women and served in our U.S. military. It is about approximately 19 million U.S. veterans who are still with us today and the millions who have preceded them since the American Revolution. Many served their communities at first, responders, teachers, healthcare workers, or church leaders. Some are business owners, farmers, company workers, and retirees, many like the likes of you. Veterans are a very diverse group, represented by men and women of every economic and ethnic and religious background. They come from every state and territory. They come from beyond, all committed, and to defend America with their life, called upon to do so. From fighting terrorism, defeating fascism, and liberating slaves, veterans have a record of remarkable accomplishment throughout our nation's history. Military service is not for the faint of heart, though. I can tell you that from my own experience, and some of you could do as well. Most civilian jobs do not require risk to life or limb. No other occupation subjects employees to criminal charges for disobeying their boss. Unlike members of military, civilians can live where they want and can quit whenever they want to. But that doesn't happen in the military, does it? Transitional challenges, we may call it, the stress of military life and the feelings of isolation, all factors into include suicide, a rate among veterans that is more than 50% higher than that of a non-veteran adult. The stigma of seeking help needs to end. If we are going to stop suicide, it's a crucial part that we look at this issue much more differently than prior generations. If we wait for someone to make an attempt before we reach out, there is a very good chance that it will be too late. Veterans value courage, and it takes courage to help. We must be proactive. We need to ask and encourage veterans to seek help before they pass to a point of no return. The bonds that we form in the military are unlike any other. A good American Legion post fosters an environment that helps continue such bonds and creates new ones. Very few of us are trained counselors and mental health professionals, but we are capable of listening and referring to follow-up. The National Crisis Line, I thought this was important that you should know. We can do that. The number is 988. The extension is 1 for veteran. Most kindergartners know the 911. It's not as hard if we know 988. It's up to us. It's up to us to ensure that the 988 becomes just as widely known. By calling 988 now, we can prevent a 9/11 later. The American Legion also has to be the one website. If you've ever decided to go to that website, and I hope you do, it's www.betheone.org. Visit it, learn from it, spread it around, and tell others. Homelessness, another problem with veterans. It's another tragic outcome that is too often connected to military service. It is estimated that America has 60,000 veterans who are now homeless. That is greater than the entire population of Carson City, Nevada. Though veterans comprise approximately 7% of the U.S. population, they are 11% of our nation's homeless. The best way to prevent a veteran from becoming homeless is to hire one. It's not only good policy, but it's a smart business for an employer who values skill, discipline, and patriotism. It is fitting that on this Veterans Day, we be observed so close to Election Day, and it is also that the veterans who have preserved our constitutional rights for 246 years. For many of them, this nation was worth enduring long separations from their families, missing births of their children, freezing in sub-zero temperatures. I know that because I was in Alaska at 70 below in the 4th and 9th Infantry, and that's where we had to go to protect from those who would want to invade us. Even sweating in the Sierra, sacrificing their health, and far too often losing their lives. When a politician laments to the cost of veterans program, it is up to us to remind them the cost of being a veteran. Whether it's exposure to burn pits or other toxins, many veterans today continue to pay the high price for their military service. Stephen mentioned to me, Colonel, said to me that there's another program today for some toxins that were maybe you might have been exposed to, and we can talk about later, so I wanted to bring that out too. And so we never know what elements we may be exposed to when we serve our country here and abroad. It is up to us to endure that they always have the access, that veterans always have the access to high quality health care and benefits reflecting the thanks of a grateful nation. 104 years ago on November 11th, 1918, the guns of the world fell silent. An armistice was signed and the Great War was over. Unfortunately, World War I was not the war to end all wars, as many have hoped. Veterans are not only responsible for defending nations during time of war, but it's the imposing presence of our great military that has acted as a deterrent to would-be aggressors. The veterans of the United States military have not only fought wars, they deserve our gratitude for preserving them. And while today we rejoice and honor the service of American veterans, we also remember the wise words of General Douglas MacArthur. Soldiers, above all other people, pray for peace. God bless you for being here today. God bless our veterans. God bless America. Thank you all again for coming. Make sure you recognize our ROTC students today before they leave and say hi to you to them. All right? God bless each and every one of you. Thank you for coming. You're up. You're on somewhere else in the world. Okay. Our tap player got a little emotional.